வணக்கம். நவ் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு டேக் அப் அனதர் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் அண்ட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் சப்ஜெக்ட், ஹவு டு அரைவ் அட் தி என்பிஏ டேட், பிகாஸ் ஐடென்டிஃபைங் என்பிஏ டேட் இஸ் வெரி மச் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் அண்ட் தெர் இஸ் அ ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் செட் ஆஃப் ரூல்ஸ். தட் இஸ் ஃபார் தி இயர் 2019-2020, தட் இஸ் திஸ் இயர், the due date has to be calculated like this: any loan sanctioned on or after 2/1/2020, you need not bother, all those advances are standard. Any dues, that is all dues have been paid, only one due is pending, if that due falls on or after 2/1/2020, then that advance you have to treat it as standard. So any loans sanctioned on or after 2/1/2020 is standard. Any dues that fall after 2/1/2020, you have to treat it as standard, because 2020 is a leap year. Then how to arrive at this date? So the dues for EMI for the principal plus interest on term loan and CCE due as on 1/1/2020. That is, dues you have to calculate up to 1/1/2020 has to be paid on or before 33/2020. If you add all these days, you will get only 90 days. That means, the as per IRAP norms, the dues have to be paid within 90 days when it is due. So if it is not paid, then you have to treat that advance as NPA. In this case, the due, you have to calculate due as on 1/1/2020. So 1 you have to take, then January 30 days, that means totally 31 days, February 29 days, then March 30 days. So if you add, you will get 90 days. And if the dues have not, dues as on 1/1/2020 has not been paid before 30th of March of 2020, then those advances you have to treat as substandard. If it is paid, then that is standard. That is why I said the any amount sanctioned on or after 2/1/2020, if you add, you will get only 90 days. Then that means it has to be paid 31/3/2020. If the loans are sanctioned on 2/1/2020, then that account will become NPA for the next year and not for this year. So 90 days norms you have to careful. That's why I once again repeat, any loan sanctioned on or after 2/1/2020, you have to treat it as standard. Otherwise, even you need not bother about those advances with reference to NPA working. This is the first stage. Second stage, non-leap year, how to calculate. Once again, for this advance, same rule is applicable. Any loans sanctioned, we will take the year as 2020-2021. That is for the next year, how to arrive at. Because next year will be the non-leap year. Any loan sanctioned on or after 1/1/2020. In leap year, it is 2/1/2020, because there are 29 days. One day is reduced. So you have to reduce one day. So any loan sanctioned on or after 1/1/2021, you need not bother, because all those advances will be standard assets. Same is the case, all dues which have been due after 1/1/2021, then that advance you have to treat it as standard. You need not bother. But provided there should not be any overdue. Even if it is overdue, you have to calculate. Suppose if November is overdue, then that account will automatically become NPA. But December due, if it is due as on 31st December. So any loan that is due on any dues, any loan, any term loan, any EMI, if it is due on 31 12, 2020, all those dues have to be paid on or before 33/2021. So that means 90 days. If one day exists, that is, it exists 90 days, as on 31/3/2021, then that account will become NPA. So once again, I'll repeat, in the case of leap year, it is any loan sanctioned on or after 2/1/2020, that is for the year 2019-2020. For non-leap year, we will take 2020-2021 as non-leap year. Then any loan due on or after, any loan sanctioned on or after 1/1/2021, any dues fall after 1/1/2021, then you have to treat it as standard. This is a thing you have to bear in mind. You add, you, if the due date exceeds within 90 days, you have to confirm. So anything, the due date for this falls on 33/2020 in the case of leap year, as well as in the year non-leap year also. This is a thing you have to bear in mind. Now I want to simply explain how to arrive at NPA due date, because you have to be very, very careful. In the mid-year also, NPA due date will come. You have to be very, very careful to calculate NPA due date before 2/1/2020. This leap year concept is not there, because the leap year concept of NPA calculation applicable only after the dues as on 1/1/2020. So if any loan falls before the day, 90 days now is clear. I want to say, if, let us take one example. If the due date for the loan is 26/2019, then you have to first calculate 90 days. So for June, remaining days are 10, July 31 days, August 31 days, September 18, because 10, 31, 41, 72 plus 18. So the loan due as on 26/2019 has to be paid on or before 18/9/2019. Otherwise, that account you have to treat it as NPA, because that exceeds 90 days. That is, the NPA date is 19/9/2019. You do by calculating any date, you take the due date as 26/2019, you add 90 days, then fix the due date. If the dues have not been paid before that date, on or before the date, then you have to treat that advance as NPA. So you have to identify the NPA date correctly, because lot of benefits the customers may lose, bankers may gain because of NPA. Even for SARFAESI also, identification of NPA date is very much important. And for subsidy adjustment, even for interest subvention, everything, identification of NPA date is very, very important. Let us take another example. If the loan due date is 5/8/2019, so it is 5th August. So remaining days in August is 26, September 30, October 31, November 3. So the due date for the payment of 5/8/2019 has to be paid on or before 3/11/2019. If it exceeds, that is, the payment exceeds that date, that is 90 days, the NPA date is 4/11/2019. You do this exercise, then only you will come to a correct identification. This you have to do at your office. Even you can this work to your staff. This is just like a game you have to do it. So this is a thing I want to say, because few members, they asked doubt. That's why I have released this presentation separately. So once again, I repeat, for leap year, any loans, you have to take the cutoff, NPA cutoff date as 2/1/2020 for the leap year. Any loan sanctioned on or after that date, don't you worry. Before that date, that is before 1/1/2020 is the due date for which all dues have to be paid on or before 33/2020. If it is not paid as on 31/3/2020, that account will become NPA. Same is the case with non-leap year. We will take the year as 2020-2021. So any loan sanctioned on or after 1/1/2021, you need not bother, all those advances will be treated as standard. So you have to arrive at the due date, previous due date, that is 31/12/2020. The due as on 31/12/2020 has to be paid on or before 33/2021. Otherwise, that account you have to treat it as NPA. I think you are all very clear with my presentation. I request once again, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, Ravindran V. And thank you for watching this video presentation. Nandri, Vanakkam.